Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series where we try to dig a little deeper into the story and the lore and, well, the general Easter eggs in this game. So there's a splicer right over there. So let's, hi. Are you something I haven't researched yet? Yeah, okay. There we go, Houdini splicers. So there we go. There's another Acuvox here. We're still in Fort Frolic, by the way. Got a bit distracted by that splicer over there, but we're still in Fort Frolic. Heading towards the record store in anticipation of Mr. Cobb, I think. Artist Feud.
I've worked the meatball beat in Little Italy, and even I'm shocked at the cold blood that oozes out of these artistic types. This broad Culpepper and that fruit job Cohen are in some kind of feud. And Cohen's looking for my security detail to pick sides. The next thing I know, I'm called into Ryan's office to talk about the whole mess. Goddamn nutjob artists.
So, yeah. Confirming again that the artists in here are a bit crazy. There's a corpse between the door here. I don't think we can actually enter it right now. So the Gardener Deluxe Modern. We can enter that, so let's head on further. And, well, Le Marquis d'Epoque. That seems interesting. This is also, if I put myself right here, I think, this is the way the original demo started out off for the original Bioshock. Bioshock has had a tradition of making demos that don't actually get into the game. So the levels you see in the trailers, the demos, are always a bit different. Well, quite a bit different than what we can see in the final game. But I think this is where we start off in the original demo. Let's quickly hack the vending machine here. There we go. Let's see what ammo we can buy. We have most of what's here, sadly. There are incendiary bolts. Don't really need them right now. We have not that much money for the moment. You might already have noticed that there aren't any little sisters and big daddies in this area, but there are little sister vents. So we'll be seeing them sooner rather than later. But we're gonna have to wait a little for that. So look at that! Crabs! But let's enter this building over here. We have a bolt shot down if it's needed for when we accidentally break the glass here. But let's enter. And it's creepily dark in here. The Marquis d'Epoque Tobacco Store. So, more items downstairs. Look at that. So we need to head downstairs eventually, but there's a turret over there. There we go. Let's hack that and make it ours. Let's clean out the cash registry. And, well, this is the alcohol and tobacco store. And I think we can look down here already. It's a... one of the few levels that actually has multiple layers, the few rooms that has multiple layers. So we have another look outside. So the fish were spooked by us and we can see the Fleet Hall sign over there. So this is kind of the alleyway we went through at the beginning of the game. And there's the fish again. We don't need to hack this, I think. We don't really need to. So let's take a look around here because this is quite an interesting area. Because there's a power to the people station here. There we go. So we have another choice here. There's a lot of nice things here still. The crossbow is of course really nice. Does already a lot of damage. We can increase that further. But I think I'm going to go for the grenade launcher damage increase first. Since that will allow us to quickly take out multiple splices. There we go. Fully upgraded one weapon. Another trophy. And now of course... splicers have entered the building. So let's search this corpse. Anti-personnel rounds. Seems like this guy was shot to death. Fancy cigarettes. And there's a code next to it. 7774. Which we might be able to use later on. So fancy cigarettes.
Some hired Betty tried to sell me on those fancy Oxford Club ciggies. No thanks. I told her I'm a nickel time man. Always will be. Why? Well, they smoke good. Cost half a damn. Who cares if the things are made out of seashells and fish eggs?
So a bit of information about the store itself here. Not that interesting. But we have the code. So 7774 is a code we might be able to use later on. So let's head back upstairs, because there's a lot going on out there. So I was kind of mistaken. I thought this led towards the record store. I was wrong. I'm telling you again, this is From a Heart by me. So I need to remember what's in the game. So this is not actually where the record store is located. Oh, hello. So let's let them deal with that. And we'll head upstairs. Okay, there's another Houdini Spicer. Okay. He kind of ignored me there. So yeah, we're gonna head upstairs towards Poseidon Plaza then.
Allow me to draw back the curtain.
Well, apparently you did. There's also a Gatherer's Garden over there, which I might actually go to first. We haven't really checked out the rest of the upper area here. So let's take a look, shall we? So there's somebody crashed through here again. They do like to destroy the railings. But hey, let's open up the Gatherer's Garden first. There we go. We don't have that much Adam, actually. I thought we had more. But as you can see, there's a lot of upgraded plasmids. Upgraded versions of the ones we have. And one new one, Cyclone Trap. Launches splices into the air and hurts them badly on the way down. But the rest, we're going to have to see when we get more Adam. Let's whack these two things as well. Don't think I'm going to hack them anymore, because the damage they receive from trying to heal is actually pretty minimal compared to what we can dish out at the moment. So, let's head towards... Okay, was distracted again. Towards Poseidon Plaza, and that should lead us to one of the apprentices of Sander Cohen. Frozen Tunnel. And there we have Martin Finnegan. Apparently able to see us around here, which I don't really know how he does that. So let's drop that corpse down. Quite a bit of loot, and let's listen to the Iceman Cometh.
You think you're gonna finish me in here, you old fruit? In the saps you tossed in this meat locker, I'll panic like rabbits. I just watched and waited. And when they started to kick, I started to scavenge. Made myself a little splicer cocktail, I did. You can't come in from the cold, and you gotta grow ice over your heart. And the Iceman cometh, Sander, baby. The Iceman fucking cometh.
The Iceman cometh. And that's actually referring to an American play with the same name, which doesn't really have a lot of connections to this place, but well, it's theater, I suppose, and that's referring to the art. So we are actually in a frozen hell, and there we have Mr. Finnegan indicating that he wants us to follow him, which we actually should do, because I don't think we can actually move further. But let's check around here first. So you can see that these guys are actually alive, because they have health bars over them. You have a plasmid which can freeze enemies, and this is what it should look like when you do. The weird thing is that they're still alive, so we can't actually kill them, which we're not going to do right now. Let's check this. This is a crossbow, so let's melt this down. Give me the crossbow, thank you. And an automatic hack tool. But if we go too far, then we get frozen over ourselves.
Grape finally sent someone. Son of a bitch left me to freeze. I've got a pose all picked out for you.
So Martin Finnegan dozed himself with a lot of winter blast, which caused him to survive in this freezing hellhole where Sander Cohen left him to die, and actually made him pretty powerful in the process as well. So now we can see we're in at the end of the same room we were in previously. And there are a lot more extra splicers which Martin Finnegan has actually posed for us. And when we get closer, I think if I remember correctly, I think they should come to life. Because we could actually try to... I'm going to actually whack this thing as well. Just so they don't heal. We can actually smack these, which I'm going to do. Because if you set them on fire, they actually come back, as you can see. Oh, is he actually trying to help us? It looks like he's attacking Martin Finnegan. So if I actually... I actually didn't know that. So if I melt these guys, they're gonna help me fight him. So let's set him on fire. And whack him a few times. There we go. And now these... Oh, that's actually funny. I never tried that before.
Take a photo of him and place it in the quad tick. I'm feeling full like an expectant mama.
What the fuck, Owen? Please, shut up. So I actually didn't know that. I'm learning something new as well. If you free the splicers locked in here, they actually help you out in the fight against Martin Finnegan. Interesting. Let's take a picture of Martin Finnegan. There we go. Another one for the masterpiece. Yep, thank you. Let's close that.
Yes. No, that was the wrong button. In the frame. Let's see what we've got here.
And he has actually a tonic on his body. Frozen Field, very, very aptly, of course. Leave your foes out in the cold with Frozen Field. You take less damage from cold and can freeze enemies when you hit them with a wrench. Which is actually a really nice one. I am actually gonna switch that out with... I'm actually doubting. Maybe I shouldn't. I'm gonna wait with that. Because freezing enemies, well, it disables them momentarily, but you can't damage them at the same time. So if you saw that when I destroyed the splicer over here, that was over here, you actually shatter them and you don't get any loot as well. So that might be a bad option in this case. Some more enzyme samples, apparently. Let's search these guys. They're dead. They're all dead. We can go back to the masterpiece now and just put it in there, which I'm going to do because you get something every time you put a picture in, so it's worth going back each time. So let's see. I'm going to go for telekinesis for right now, and let's head back downstairs. Nice. Here's splicer. Sounds like spider splicers. Okay. Did he just... Oh! There we go, there we go. That's the trigger. So now we have Big Daddy's here as well. Yeah, he's apparently not afraid of you. So we never actually researched the bouncer. Because, well, we haven't encountered any since we got the research camera. So there we go. Bouncer, increased damage and bouncers are vulnerable to armor-piercing rounds. And now I think we've photographed every type of splicer. Every type of enemy. So there's the end of that. And there we have another trophy. So we got a trophy for researching every enemy. And now we got a trophy for fully researching the tuck splicer. So let's take a few pictures of the little sister as well. Another level. So more increases to max health and Eve. Let's take two more pictures since we can. Let's take a few of the Big Daddy as well. There we go. And of course now we could try and kill it. I'm first gonna add the picture to the masterpiece, so here we go.
It's coming together, yes. But there will always be doubters. You don't doubt me, do you? I could never stomach doubters.
There we go, he hates doubters. And well, who wouldn't? Well, okay, right. I never got to show you this, but this is what a little sister does. So she sticks the needle into a body and then she does that. She drinks the blood. And it's actually pretty, pretty creepy. So she drinks the blood and filters out the atom that was in the splicer's body. And that's how she is the source of a lot of, atom. So now we're gonna try and take out the Big Daddy. I think I don't have a lot to prepare with because I don't think there's any explosives nearby. So I got a little too close to the little sister over there, but I don't think there's explosives nearby. I could bring a few back from in here because I think there was a gas canister over here. So if I take that... there we go. Let's take one of these frozen gas canisters. Okay, don't explode, please. Please don't. I've done that way too much in this playthrough. So now, I don't think... No, he doesn't have a little sister. He doesn't... Okay. Yeah, there we go. So he doesn't have a little sister, but he has... But he just... Yeah, okay. There we go. So let's put that down. Take the proximity mines. And I think he should be getting a... Yeah, there we go. A little sister. So let's combine this gas canister with six of these. Let's equip the electric box. Hopefully the little sister doesn't come this way. And then we can actually shove that in his face. And kill him easily. There we go. That's probably the fastest we've taken down a big daddy. So let's rescue the little... Oh, what the hell happened there? That was her syringe that pushed me out of the way. Out of the way. So let's rescue her. Shwa! Ooh. There we go.
The little ones have never had anyone to look to, except to me. And I am not much to speak of. You give them hope. And for this, I am grateful. I'll send something to demonstrate that gratitude.
Thank you, Tannenbaum. So we got our third little sister again. So let's gather the money from this big daddy. And well, now that we have another package waiting for us, well, just let us just... oh, hello. That was interesting. Wrench Chucky 2. Well, of course, I'm going to install Wrench Chucky 2. Greatly increases wrench damage. So let's keep taking pictures. I think I should be able to take a few more pictures. Yeah, there we go. We're actually going strong with our research here. I'm going to leave them right over there for a minute. But I might as well take him out in a minute as well. So let's take a look around here, because we haven't seen everything here as well. But first I'm going to go to the Gatherer's Garden and take our gift. Which should also have a little sister, actually. I know, she's already gone. Let's take another first aid kit and search the gift. 200 Adam, Hypnotize Big Daddy 2, and 4 first aid kits. There we go. So that's a boosted. The effect will be longer with the Hypnotize Big Daddy. I don't think we need another plasmid slot. I'm pretty happy with how it is right now. I would like another physical tonic slot, so we're going to do that. I'm going to put... I like Scrounger. I really like Scrounger. I think I'm going to do Scrounger. Yeah, there we go. So let's put Scrounger over there. And then we have Incinerate 2. Repeated use increases heat extra hot. Winter Blast 2 freezes for longer, gives more time to shatter the frozen enemy. I don't like Winter Blast. I've never really used Winter Blast. Because, well, as I said before, you don't get any loot from shattered enemies. So that's a bit sad, so I don't really use that. I am going to use Insect Swarm 2, though. So let's upgrade that. So replaced it. I'm going to upgrade Eve as well. And I think I'm going to add another Combat Tonic slot, because we're going to come across a lot more interesting ones in the future. Wrench Lurker is nice. Static Discharge is really nice, but I'm telling you, it's really dangerous when using it nearby Big Daddies. If you get struck from by another splicer, the Big Daddy will aggro on you immediately. So let's go with Wrench Lurker. I really like the stealth aspect of this game, so we can actually do more damage. We also don't make any noise by walking anymore. Well, barely any noise. So that's also very nice. And Naval, now that we're here, I think I'm going to show you another really interesting room. Because a few of the rooms here have opened up. And we can actually enter Cohen's Collection of Fine Art. Which is another really creepy room. So let's head in. So this is supposed to be a museum for Andrew Ryan. Not again, Sander Cohen's collection. But it turned out a bit more gruesome than it was before. So that's nothing, there's nothing in here. So we can see a few paintings, which is pretty nice. But then around here, there's another, well, very, very gruesome scene as a shark goes by the window. So this is an entire family. Murdered and sat at the table. So we can see that the father has slit his own wrists right here. The mother has been tied to the chair, and this little girl is unbound, luckily, but well, since her parents are presumably dead, and well, she is also right now. This is pretty gruesome. There's another audio diary here as well, the doubters. So we heard that Santa Cohen doesn't like doubters, clearly.
Rapture is going to hell. And why? Because of them. Always behind the scenes, at the Lyceum, at the galleries in Soho, even down here in this so-called utopia. The doubters. But Ryan understands. We're simpatico. Yes, there's blood in the streets. Yes, people sometimes disappear. And those awful little girls. Well, I suppose the doubters think you can paint a picture without soiling your smock.
So yeah, he actually took a little sister and murdered her here. Which is actually bad, just terrible. I mean, come on, man. So yeah, if you were doubting, like, he hates the doubters, Xander Cohen is one crazy psychopath. There's also something very funny here. That's what I was wanting to show, because there was a little hat on this turret, which I've always found a little funny. But hey, there we go. $3. Can we have more? No, $3. There we go. So we have now 3 safes we can open. I think there's only one that's really of interest, but let's open all of them. I have 2 auto hacks, so let's check this out. And now, of course, we get ambushed again. So there's another Houdini splicer that's trying to kill us. Don't know where he is, actually. So let's open the other safe with an auto hack. Probably gonna be the last one that I open. 6 armor piercing rounds, $32. That's actually not bad. Let's hack the last one. I can actually buy out these ones for $32, so let's do that as well. And more film and an Eve hypo. Oh, for fuck's sake. I mean, I electrified her way before everything else happened. Yeah, okay, nothing. So, that's another really, really creepy room owned by Xander Cohen. Let's heal up, because I think I'm going to take one of those first aid kits up there as well. So I think there was one in here. Yeah, there we go. We're filled up on the armor piercing round, so that's not going to help us. I do like the coffee here. Thank you for the coffee, because that actually adds a lot of Eve. More than you might think. So next up, we need to kill 2 more guys and take pictures of them. So we have Cobb in the... okay, hello Big Daddy. We have Cobb in the record store, that we know. And then we have a third one. Subject research complete on the spider splicers. There we go. Another interesting venture done. Don't know if this is the same one. I think it is. Apparently it isn't. How could we quickly take care of this guy? I have armor piercing rounds equipped. I have armor piercing rounds equipped in here. I have the electric gel here. I have the electric box. And, well, let's start off with a few grenades. No, you're not ready for dream time. So now he's gonna charge me. So I'm gonna keep the stairs in between us. Just because that actually works pretty well. And that actually doesn't do much. But hey. Let's take the... Oh. Down he goes. Another bouncer done. So if you don't use the explosives, that actually takes a lot longer to kill a Big Daddy. Did I actually take pictures of you, by the way? I didn't. There we go. And rescue!
No! No! No!
No, no, yes, yes. Let it go. Let it all go. There we go. 2 out of 3 in this area, probably. So let's search this guy again. You're welcome.
Thank you for helping me.
You are welcome. So let's head through the frozen hellhole again and into another interesting area. Because as I said before, I really like Fort Frolic. Just because there's a variety of nicely little areas. Well, rather large ones, the ones that I'm going to enter right now. Because there's actually 2 kind of hub areas in this in Fort Frolic. We have the Atrium and then we have Poseidon Plaza. And Poseidon Plaza is where horrors come to life. And I'll show you in a minute. So that's horrible as well. Okay. Oh, for fuck's sake. I don't know actually if I... Yeah, okay. There we go. So there's a lot of spider splicers in this area. And their crawling is actually creepy enough on its own. Yeah, that's all I got. I do have telekinesis though, so I can throw bodies at you. Are there other ones? Hi! Jesus Christ, there's all of them. So yeah, with telekinesis I'm a bit overpowered right now. But well, there's a lot of enemies here as well. So, as you can see with the spider splicers, since we researched them, we get their hearts as first aid kits. So we're not gonna run out of first aid kits anytime soon right here. And the music changed again. There's a lot of rooms here. I think I'm gonna first start off with the lower ones. Jesus Christ. There's spider splicers everywhere. This place is locked. There's a staircase and there's more items downstairs. But it's locked right now. It's actually pretty elaborate how you can open that up, and I'm going to show you either in a minute or in the next episode. And as you can see, there's a big daddy up there. But let's see, let's first go to Sinclair Spirits, a name that we're going to come across more often later on as well, Sinclair. So there we go! This is more than a bit creepy, so I'm going to show you right here. I kind of was forgetting in which room the most interesting ones were. So there's all these plaster statues at the entrance here. So guiding us towards that corpse over there on the table. And there's another camera here, so let's take a few pictures. Oh, subject research complete. So let's hack it, buy it out, and there we go, our camera. There's a corpse on the table here as well. So these guys are supposedly dead. But we can't loot this guy right now for some reason, because, well, most of the plaster statues we can't. There's a very, very interesting thing in this, well, cafe, bar, whatever you want. So this is another one of those statues. There we go, more stuff in here. This door is locked, but we can actually enter that room, because there is, underneath the bar here, is a switch. Which actually is gonna unleash hell. So I'm first gonna check everything here. $12, thank you very much. And there's a lot of booze in the wall. But let's press the switch. So now we can enter that room. We're gonna do that immediately. And that leads us to the basement with a corpse over there in the corner. Very creepily posted there. Another one of those plastered corpses. So let's go first for the interesting thing. There's a power to the people station here. Very interesting. I think I'm gonna go for the chemical thrower consumption rate. Because I'm gonna start using that more to kill big daddies. So there we go. I'm gonna equip the wrench, because if we turn around... Hello! So those plaster statues aren't really dead. So that's the one that was on the chair over there. Hopefully that didn't spook you too much, because even I knew what was going to happen and I jumped. So let's hack the safe as well, buy it out with $120, because I don't really care at this point. And, well, an automatic hack tool, thank you for that. So the music is actually really distracting here, because it's happy, happy music. But when we go outside, it's become a lot worse, because the woman over here on the left is gone. The corpse on the table is still there, but remember those 6 guys in the hallway? Well, they're all gone. What that single button press does while actually accessing the power to the people station is revive every plastered splicer in the entire area in Fort Frolic completely. So now we're gonna constantly get charged by plastered spider splicers. I kid you not. So we're gonna probably have some in a minute as well. And the fact that we're still being followed by spotlights isn't helping. They're also a lot more silent sometimes than the normal splicers. So we're gonna be attacked more often. So the switch also opens up the staircase down there, which is actually the room of nightmares for me. I got scared shitless down there. So without further ado, let's go down. So this is probably, I think, the largest open space in the game. I think the largest open room in the game, and it's just completely empty, with a few of these mannequin stands and a thin layer of water on the floor. So if we go towards the corner, which is the only thing that has something of interest, is there's a tonic over here with a few proximity mines. So let's take that extra nutrition 2, which is actually useless because we have the better one, and we don't really use that, so let's leave it at that. We can check out the storage crate, which also has an automatic hack tool and 2 proximity mines. And if we turn around, the mannequins have moved a bit, and there's plaster spider splicers in the water, and the music has completely stopped. The funny thing about these guys is they're statues, as you can see. They stand perfectly still. But if you turn around and look at them again, their positions have changed slightly. See? Did you just see that? That guy just moved. And there's another one! That one, Jesus Christ, I'm scared. That one came closer. Oh, for fuck's sake. I know what's gonna happen and I'm still scared. So we can't use Electro Bolt here. Well, we could, but that's not gonna solve anything. And you hear water everywhere. I'm having goosebumps right now. Just, and I know what's going to happen. I mean, these guys are alive, obviously. And then there they go. So I could go with Electro Bolt and finish this quickly. Okay, that was not Electro Bolt. That was Electro Bolt. And heal myself a bit, because that kills them all outright. But I mean, this is terrible, right? The first time. Oh, for fuck's sake! There we go. That's what I mean. They just come back. This is terrible. So there's one for each mannequin in the room. The first time I went into this room, I thought the room was clear. I hit one of the mannequins, turned around, and got scared shitless. So these are also spider splicers. So I mean, we have maximum research on these guys, but still we can't do all that much against these guys. I'm gonna go for anti-personnel rounds as well, because that's gonna help us out. So I think I kind of did something like this and then turn around. Oh no, now it's not happening. I think it still does. There we fucking go. I hate this. I hate this fucking area. There we go. There's another one. I hate this level. I hate this level. I still hate this level. Thank you. Okay. I'm scared because there's still one mannequin. Oh, for fuck's sake. There we fucking go. Die already. Oh, God. Okay. So there should be one left. But they just appear out of nowhere for some reason. I mean, there's one left here. Where the fuck is it? Where the fuck is he? I'm just gonna... Okay, I think we're fine. No, we're not fine. God. Jesus, motherfucking Christ. And it just appear out of nowhere. There's nothing on the ceiling. There's nothing. I'm just gonna stand in the corner here. I'm just gonna leave this place. It still gives me nightmares. Still gives me... Oh, fuck off. Stop making noises! They're all dead, I think. Because all the mannequins are... I'm hearing myself, right? The water is... Jesus. Okay. enough torturing me. I think I'm gonna end the episode here. And I'm hearing noises. Okay, I'm gonna end the episode here. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget, I'm gonna stand in the corner. Don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel. Because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching. And I hope to see you in the next episode. Where I probably don't get scared shitless that I poop my pants. Goodbye.